Hello everyone, today I will introduce an inverted fluorescence microscope MF53-N uses an infinity achromatic optical system with long working distance plan achromatic objectives and eyepiece. Excellent weak fluorescence imaging using turntable switching mode can work with UV, VB, GY, etc. Various fluorescence and other common fluorescent dyes can observe DAPI, FIT, TRIT, Alexa Fluor series, CY3 series, and other common fluorescent dyes. Widely used in CTC detection, FRET, cellular immunity, etc. field. The microscope body is compact and stable, which greatly meets the shockproof requirements. These are multi-band light source digital controller, bright field light source controller, fluorescent illuminator, phase contrast ring plate, EXC mount adapter, CT telescope, objectives, eyepiece. Push the 10x, 20x, 40x phase contrast ring plate horizontally from the right side. First, remove the water drop plate. Remove the cover of the nose piece. Install the objectives in order from low magnification to high magnification. First, raise the nose piece. Align the bottom of the illuminator with the card slot and push it in. Then use a 2.5 screwdriver to tighten the screw from the right side. Put the water drop plate back on the stage and align the hole with the direction of rotation of the objectives. Remove the two dust-proof covers and put the eyepiece into the tube. Plug in the connecting line and power line. Align the mount of the light source with the microscope. Use a 3.0 screwdriver to tighten the left and right screws. Then connect the multi-band controller to the light source. The red dot should be aligned with the red dot. When you hear a tick, it means you have successfully connected it. The red dot on the other side repeat the operation just now. Connect the power cord to the adapter. Align the port on the other side of the power cord with the mouse of the touchscreen controller. It will be automatically locked after insertion. Unscrew the screw here and install it directly. First, use a 2.0 screwdriver to unscrew the dust cover. Install the interface. Tighten the screws. And then unscrew the camera dust proof cover. Install the camera tightly.